scripture that we have? Tom. Tom.
Yes, it's that time again. Welcome to the Rock of Ages Ministry Television Program, an international evangelistic ministry reaching souls around the world for Jesus. A ministry with signs and wonders, healing and deliverance. With your host, a Latter-day Apostle, a man with God's vision for today, one who's reaching out to the lost at any cost around the world for Jesus.
I feel like praising him. Let's give the Lord a praise clap. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And welcome today to the Rock of Ages Ministries television program. And I tell you, we have another power-packed telecast in store for you today. And I tell you, it's a very special topic and is backed by popular demand. And what I mean is this is going to be a part two of this, I don't know how many part segment. And it is walking in true holiness. Amen. Now let that just, you know, digest into your spirit. Walking in true holiness. Because we need to understand if we walk in true holiness, we're going to be used by God in the way that he originally predestined us to be used by him. Amen. That we'll be doing like a work of Moses. You know, we watch the movie The Ten Commandments, and we see this great work that Moses did. But God is no respecter of persons.
Amen.
And Moses just found a way to walk in the pleasantness of God, where he was walking in obedience. And today, that's what we're going to teach you about. But not only that you can do a great work for the Lord, but that you can be ultimately blessed by him. Because he said, if you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. And for those of you that need prayer or counseling, I want you to avail yourselves to the prayer counseling information, hotline numbers that are on your screen, area code 504-613-7234. For those of you that are in the New Orleans area and the Acadiana area, you may call 337-706-7262. And just avail yourselves to our email address as well as our website. You may visit our website 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for your convenience. Amen?
Amen.
And we want to first go over, and I want you to meet our guests. amen, real briefly. And first up, we have Dr. June Paul of Operation Outreach for Souls Ministries. And then we're going to let the others just follow along as they introduce themselves in their own way. Welcome, Dr. Paul, at this time.
Thank you, Dr. Apostle Bailey. Praise the Lord and all of my sisters in Christ and to everyone who's viewing this service. I'm June Brooks Paul, Operation Outreach for Souls.
Amen. Would you tell us just a little bit about your ministry? What are you doing?
Well, over the last 43 years, we've done a number of things that the Lord directed us to do. Street ministry, currently radio and television, and house church ministry, Bible studies, and jails, nursing homes, and just a variety
Amen.
Of things in the Lord.
And I guess it's, you know, we can tell just by the name, Operation Outreach for Souls.
And
so you're reaching out for souls.
We're in the Upper Ninth Ward, too, for ministry along with
Amen.
House Church
Praise
presently.
God. And we have also on the set Evangelist Jill Brandel. Amen. Praise God. Would you introduce yourself in your own way?
Praise the Lord, Apostle Bailey. And
Amen.
Welcome to everyone in the television audience. I am Evangelist Jill Brandel of God's Children and Revival Ministries. One of the things I do is on the set. I've got flags out in the front. And I just love to praise the Lord. I've done a number of things over the last 20 years, including children's ministry, ministry in nursing homes. I've worked with different churches, specifically in Slidell, where I've been the last 3.5 years. Really whatever I can do, you know, to be a blessing to the body of Christ. And I am an evangelist, so my heart is souls, just like my sister here with Operation Outreach for Souls. You know, Dr. Paul and I have done some things together, too. So, again, just really whatever I can do to be a blessing, and I'm thankful to be here on the television broadcast today. I've been here for almost 4 years, and I look at this away. This is another avenue where I can reach out and reach souls with the gospel. Thank you, Apostle Bailey.
Amen. Praise God. And Pastor Josie Phillips, would you just let the Lord take your liberty at this time?
I'm Josie Phillips, Pray the Word, Say the Word Ministry. And we've been in ministry since 94. We have the Children's Columbus Street Children's Center. We're on Columbus and Odoshawa. We have a food bank. We minister to the hurting people. We go to the nursing home. We rescue women that are coming out of jail that has no means of support. We give clothes. We set clothes out. We feed the hungry. There's so many things, but the past couple of years, we've been children's ministry. After Katrina, we got relocated to Florida, and the Lord spoke to me. He says, you need to go back to New Orleans to be a missionary to New Orleans. And so God is so awesome. We minister to mind, soul, body. We have a 24-hour prayer line number. If you need prayer, we will touch and agree. We teach the Word of God, how to stand on that Word of God. God is an awesome God. And I just thank God for Apostle Bailey for inviting me here today.
Amen, which is my pleasure. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. And we also have, last but not least, Evangelist Celestine. Would you introduce yourself in your own way?
Yes. I'm Helen Celestine, and I have New Wine Ministries. It's evangelistic. Of course, whatever I find myself to do, whatever I find my hands to do, that's what I do. I have a prison ministry where I teach every other week women. I also have a shofar ministry and visit the sick, whatever evangelism is, whatever that encompasses, that's what I do.
And
God is so good, and I'm just thankful for the invitation today, and I want to be a blessing to the public, and I just thank God for this time.
Amen. Well, you're a blessing already.
Amen.
And today she'll be doing her television debut with Rock of Ages Ministries. But let's give a hand clap to all of our guests.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
As we're getting ready for the reading of the Word, and we want to take this, for those of you that are in, that have your Bibles in your homes, and those in the studio, of course, turn to 2 Chronicles the seventh chapter. And we're going to start right about the 14th verse, and we're going to move on over to the 21st verse. If you would, Evangelist Brendel, would you do the honors?
Sure. I'm reading from the New American Standard Bible, starting in verse 14. And my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then I will hear from heaven, will forgive their sin, and will heal their land. Now my eyes shall be open and my ears attentive to the prayer offered in this place. For now I have chosen and consecrated this house that my name may be there forever, and my eyes and my heart will be there perpetually. And as for you, if you walk before me as your father David walked, even to do according to all that I have commanded you, and will keep my statutes and my ordinances, then I will establish your royal throne as I covenanted with your father David, saying, you shall not lack a man to be ruler in Israel. But if you turn away and forsake my statutes and my commandments, which I have set before you, and shall go and serve other gods and worship them, then I will uproot you from my land, which I have given you. And this house which I have consecrated for my name I will cast out of my sight. I will make it a proverb and a byword among all peoples. As for this house which was exalted, everyone who passes by it will be astonished and say, why has the Lord done thus to this land and to this house?
One may as well read
verse
that.
Verse 22. And they will say, because they forsook the Lord, the God of their fathers, who brought them from the land of Egypt, and they adopted other gods and worshiped them and served them. Therefore, he has wrought all this adversity on them.
Amen. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. And we want to set the stage with that passage of scripture, just as we're getting ready for our first speaker of the evening. But this passage helps us to understand that there are blessings through obedience and there are cursings through disobedience, or we'll say failing to obey. And so this subject, walking in true holiness and total surrender unto the Holy Spirit, is so vitally important to your Christian welfare and to your life. Amen? Because, you know, the Bible says that God wants you to have life and have life more abundantly. And so we're going to move over to our first guest of the evening, Dr. June B. Paul. Amen. And by the way, she does have a PhD, so we know that she is well-versed, not only in education, but also in the Bible. Mm-hmm. So would you take your liberty at this time and tell us a little bit about walking in true holiness and total surrender to the Holy Spirit.
Praise the Lord, Apostle Bailey. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. We just have about 4 or 5 minutes and then we'll come back to you if you don't finish. Okay. Go right ahead.
Now, I know that part one, I didn't hear part one. I'm sure a lot was said, you know, last week or last month, and my sisters have a lot to say. But as I was meditating earlier this morning, and I said, Lord, what do you want your people to hear from this vessel, walking in holiness, mm-hmm. total obedience? Now, dearly beloved, the Lord said to go from the children's standpoint.
Amen.
And to compare the children with the adults. Just a couple of things. And, you know, that topic, we as adults do understand.
Amen.
The wording. The little children may not understand it that way, but we have the responsibility of leading them and training them so that, as the scriptures say, when they are old, they won't depart. Now, yesterday, my great-grandchildren came over and we did a puppet story, amen, as we did on the streets last Saturday. And then they began to tell their stories. Now, these are 4 and a half and 5-year-old. The first one said she wanted to tell the story of I think it was Joseph. Oh, and she went on and on. And the little boy began to talk about David. I said, okay, it's my turn, and we talked about Jonah. Okay, obedience. Now listen, the Lord says we are to be obedient children. Amen. Mm-hmm. And although we get old, the Lord allows us to, we're to still have that spirit that Christ demanded and commanded that we have, so that we can be like obedient little children.
Amen.
Amen. And so that is my word that I want to share with you. You're out there now, amen, and there are many things that you need and want, but have you totally surrendered? And it begins with salvation, and the walk that you do from salvation until you meet our Lord, it's a daily walk, a daily obedient walk, mm-hmm. surrendering, and we're to stay in the Word of God, and it becomes not just a twice a day, but it becomes a lifestyle of meditating on the Word and thinking, even when you're speaking to others or you're on the job or whatever. But little children are submissive. Little children follow the leader. They know how to do that. They're so tender. Follow and obey mother and daddy. And we have our Heavenly Father. Amen. And so the ultimate goal that Christ wants to do in us, he wants us to work, to let him work his work through us. So then as we work the work that he has for us to do, then we are becoming and will become and going on to walk in total obedience, a total
true holiness and total surrender.
Yes,
to the
listen,
Holy Spirit.
I just want to leave you with this.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. I surrender. Do you surrender today? I surrender all. I surrender. I surrender all to him. Our blessed Savior, we surrender all. Total surrender. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless
Hallelujah.
You too. Let's give the Lord a hand clap for that.
Amen.
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 Total surrender.
Amen.
To the Holy Spirit. And you heard it from someone who I know is a true, dedicated woman of God who's demonstrating what she's speaking. You know, as the Bible says, we shouldn't just be hearers only, but also doers of the Word.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, without any further ado, we want to go to this first break. We have a beautiful song. It's actually a dance, a praise dance, by one of our very own guests, the one who you're going to hear from when we return, and that's Evangelist Jill Brandel. So enjoy this, and we'll be back in a moment.
To visit Rock of Ages Ministries on the web, just type into your web browser www.ronniebailey.com. You may click on links such as Missions, TV Schedule, Sermon of the Month, Contact Us, National, International, and Slideshow Galleries, just to name a few. Please add your contact information so that we can add your name to our mailing list. We would like to have the opportunity of following up with you in the future. For our international visitors, just click on your country's flag symbol located on our home page. This will change our entire website to the language of your choice. It's just that easy. Also, don't forget to sign our guest book. You may also insert your picture and comments if you choose as well. If you need prayer or counseling, please complete the information form below. One of our prayer counselors will respond as soon as we receive your request. We are committed to assisting you with your most earnest needs. Our picture gallery is also available to help acquaint you better with our ministry and the various events conducted throughout the year. You may also click on our slideshow gallery and enjoy continuous slide-by-slide, local, national, and international on our special large screen view. Our webcast channel is available to view a library of telecasts and video, organized by picture and title for your convenience.
So, just say. He
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Welcome back. Welcome back. Amen. Amen. And I tell you, I enjoyed that beautiful praise and worship dance selection by none other than Evangelist Jill Brandel. Amen. Let's give her another great hand because we're going to be hearing her pretty soon.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Speaking on true holiness. You know, the topic is really walking in holiness, but as we did part one, Evangelist Wells, as he went up to do his exhortation concerning that subject, he says the Spirit gave him that it should be walking in true holiness. Mm-hmm. And so from that point, you know, we've adopted true holiness. Mm-hmm. You know, because sometimes we have a spirit, but that spirit may not be holy.
That's true.
So we're talking about the true Holy Spirit. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to go to our next passage of scripture. Amen. And again, those of you that need prayer counseling, just avail yourselves to the prayer counseling information hotline. Numbers that are on your screen. We have prayer counselors standing by right now to receive your call. Our email address, our website is there for your convenience. And we want to go to Deuteronomy 28:1. For those of you that have your Bibles, Deuteronomy 28:1-14, and Evangelist Brendel, once again, is going to do the honors.
Yeah, thank you, Apostle Bailey. I'm reading again from the New American Standard Bible for those of you who may have just tuned into the broadcast. And it reads, "Now it shall be, if you will diligently obey the Lord your God, being careful to do all his commandments, which I command you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth.
My God.
And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, if you will obey the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city, blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the offspring of your body and the produce of your ground, and the offspring of your beast, the increase of your herd, and the young of your flock. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall you be when you go out. The Lord will cause your enemies who rise up against you to be defeated before you. They shall come out against you one way, and shall flee before you seven ways. The Lord will command the blessing upon you in your barns and in all that you put your hand to, and he will bless you in the land which the Lord your God gives you. The Lord will establish you as a holy people to himself, as he swore to you, if you will keep the commandments of the Lord your God and walk in his ways. So all the peoples of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of you. And the Lord will make you abound in prosperity, in the offspring of your body, and in the offspring of your beast, and in the produce of your ground, in the land which the Lord swore to your fathers to give you. The Lord will open for you his good storehouse, the heavens, to give rain to your land in its season, and to bless all the work of your hand. And you shall lend to many nations, but you shall not borrow. And the Lord shall make you the head and not the tail, and you shall only be above, and you shall not be underneath. If you will listen to the commandments of the Lord your God, which I charge you today, to observe them carefully, and do not turn aside from any of the words which I command you today, to the right or to the left, to go after other gods, to serve them." Thank you, Apostle Bailey.
Hallelujah. May God add another blessing to the reading of his word. Let's give the Lord a hand clap.
Amen.
For the reading of his word.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. If we wasn't in the studio, we would have been standing. Mm. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God, because God's word are pure words, as silver tried in an earthen vessel.
Yes, Lord.
Purified or sanctified seven times, which is God's number, which means divine perfection.
Amen.
Amen. That's what God's word is. It's so pure. And that's why we didn't even want to take nothing from it, and we didn't want to add nothing to it. We wanted to read it directly, even though it was the version, the American, the New American Standard version. But you also could read it through the King James or the New International Version, whichever, even the Living Bible, if you choose. Amen. But it all is going to come out the same.
Amen.
That if you obey, you will be blessed. If you disobey, all you're going to do is forfeit all of your blessings. and the devil gonna be sitting there laughing at you. You know, if the devil, you know, it's a little old saying, if you got fooled once, whoever fooled you, shame on them. But if you get fooled again, then shame on you. So the devil have robbed us, amen? You know, and even Malachi, the third chapter, speaks about how he has robbed us, you know, because of us not being obedient to what God has told us to even give as our offering. But the devil is just constantly robbing us, and we need to wisen up. We need to not go back as a dog going back to his vomit. Amen. We going back and repeating the same sins over and over. And then we wonder, we say, where's God? We say, I'm waiting on God. And God said, no, you're not. I'm waiting on you. You waiting on me, I'm here. I'm waiting on you to obey. Amen?
Amen.
So we're going to move right over. Amen. I tell you, because this is a, I tell you this, so the Spirit is has just set the stage, and we're going to go back over to the same woman of God, and she's going to share from a different note. She's going to come in and share her commentary on what God has given her concerning these two great subjects. Praise God.
Yeah, thank you again. We are talking about walking in true holiness, as Apostle Bailey said, in total surrender to the Holy Spirit. And when I was up praying this morning, like Dr. Paul was on about praying this morning, I was up praying this morning, and the Lord gave me a familiar scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, but he gave it to me in a little different way. And many of you can probably quote this. It says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Remember, we're talking about walking in holiness, being obedient, living godly.
Yes.
Well, you know, if we think about walk, when we walk by faith, it really talks about how we're living our lifestyle. I looked up the word sight in Strong's, and it's 1491, and it's E-I-D-O-S. It's pronounced idos, or idos. I'm not too good at Greek, but it means a view, i.e. a form, literal, or figurative. Okay, so we're talking about, you know, seeing things. Now, faith, you know, we know faith means trust in God completely. That's what we need to be doing. You know, we talk about that. Obviously, it's easier said than we need to trust God totally in all areas of our lives. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path.
That's right.
But I'm going to go a little further. I'm going to read verses 8 and 9 here. It says, again, I'll read 7, I'll repeat 7. For we walk by faith, not by sight. In 2 Corinthians 5, now 8 and 9, it says, we are of good courage, I say. Prefer rather to be absent from the body and to be at home with the Lord. Therefore also we have as our ambition, whether at home or absent, to be pleasing to him. I want you to look at that last word, pleasing to him. When we're obedient, we are pleasing to God. When we walk by faith and not by sight, when we trust him, we are pleasing to him. Now,
that's
here
right.
In this context, the Apostle Paul is actually speaking to the Corinthian church.
Mm-hmm.
And he's telling them to be patient, to be waiting, to, you know, they're waiting to go home and be with the Lord. I mean, a number of times I've told God, God, I really want to go home. Take me home. You know, I would love to be in heaven, love to have my new glorified body, not be sick and in pain, all things we go through here. But God's saying it's not time to go home yet. So they were told by Paul to be patient, waiting to go home. But in the meantime, whether we're on the earth, he says, or whether we're up in heaven in our glorified bodies, it says we're to be pleasing to the Lord.
That's right.
So if our lives are based on sight, the opposite of what this verse says, we're going to have trouble living holy. So many of the areas where God's people sin and fall short of God's glory, Romans 3:23, involve our senses. So God made us in him image. We know what Genesis 1:27 says, we're made in God's image. But Satan's come in, he's perverted our music, our dress, our language, and etc. So what do we have to do to overcome that? We have to speak God's word daily over our lives in order that we're going to continue to live holy for him. Now, one example that's a strong, an area that's, I guess the devil tries to be strong in many people's lives is in sexual sin. And that's the only sin, according to Paul, okay, in 1 Corinthians 6:18 and 19, is actually a sin directly against the body. How can all the other sins, Paul tells us here, are sins committed outside the body? Those would be things like lying and stealing and cheating and things we might do with our mouth that's not actually affecting our physical body. And that's an area that people, even ministers today, have trouble with. But I want to go ahead and close with Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. And the last part of the verse in King James says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. And a New American Standard Bible here says, for the mouth speaks out of that which fills the heart. So in other words, what is in your heart determines whether or not you're living a holy life before men and God, totally surrendered to Him. Thank you.
Amen.
My God, my God. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Praise
Thank
the Lord,
you, Lord Jesus.
God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For those of you that don't know Jesus as your personal Savior, I want you to repeat this prayer with me along with those in the studio. Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I know that I'm a sinner.
I know that I'm a sinner.
Please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Wash me in your blood.
Wash me in your blood.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
And be Lord of my life.
And be Lord of my life.
I receive you now.
I receive you now.
I know that I'm saved.
I know that I'm saved.
Right now.
Right now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Now, those of you that have repeated that prayer, let me be one of the first to congratulate you and welcome you to the kingdom of God. Let's give the Lord a hand clap for them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And don't touch that dial. We're going to be right back. We just saved the last segment for our two very special guests that you're going to meet in just a moment. Well, you've already met them, and that is Pastor Joseph Phillips and Evangelist Helen Celestine. But we're going to be right back with their special word from the Lord.
Our picture gallery is also available to help acquaint you better with our ministry and the various events conducted throughout the year. You may also click on our slideshow gallery and enjoy continuous slide-by-slide, local, national, and international on our special large screen view. Our webcast channel is available to view a library of telecasts and video, organized by picture and title for your convenience. Just click on the webcast channel of your choice by clicking on the appropriate symbol. For you 24 hours a day and 7 days a week for your convenience. Just type www.ronniebailey.com and sit back and relax and enjoy our website. And be sure to invite your friends as well.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
You know, I just sense that angels are just flowing, just flying all over the studio right now. You know, we're almost ready for the shofar. Amen. Glory to God. We're almost ready for the shofar, but we're going to wait till we introduce our special guests for that. Amen. But this would be also an appropriate time. Amen. But hallelujah, with the little time we have left, we want to move right to the word once again. Hallelujah. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. Those of you in your home, would you turn 1 Corinthians 3, verses 16 and 17. Hallelujah. And Evangelist Brendel, please.
Thank you, Apostle Bailey. And it reads, verse 16, do you not know that you are a temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If any man destroys the temple of God, God will destroy him. For the temple of God is holy, and that is what you are. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's just give the Lord a hand clap for the reading of his word. Since we weren't able to stand, we don't want to get in trouble with our director. Amen. Praise the Lord. But we're going to get ready to receive our first special guest. And if she would, she could at least be getting that shofar. Maybe you can start with that. Amen. Because as I say, there's an appropriate time. Amen. While there's such an awe of holiness all over the studio, and I'm sure right where you are, you can sense the Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says the Spirit speaketh expressly. So we're going to ask the Spirit to also express himself in the way of the shofar. Amen.
Amen.
Would you do the honors at this time, Pastor Josie?
Thank you, Apostle. God bless you. God bless you. I'm going to sound the shofar, and it's going to be a call to you out there. It's going to be a call for you to live in holiness. I ask you the question today, who are you? Who are you? And does good people go to heaven? I had a four-year-old that answered me, and he said, no, good people don't go to heaven. There's only one way. You must be born again. As I sound the shofar, it's a call to holiness. It's a call to repentance. It's a call for you to get your life right, line upon line. Hallelujah. And today, and I want to thank you also.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. What happens when you sound the shofar, there is a releasing an anointing, and the atmosphere is changed. It's an awesome thing when the breath of the Holy Ghost begin to blow in the place. And also the Bible says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. And there's a warfare sound. What happens when this is a sound for warfare. It pushes back powers of darkness, and it confuses the enemy. Many of you, you're familiar with the story about when they watched around the walls of Jericho, and the priest went before. In the Bible, the priest went before, and they sound the shofar. It's something about, and when I pray, I ask God to go before us to clear the way. I'd like to share also how important it is today for us to walk in holiness. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Continue.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Once you begin to know who you are in Christ, and you begin to eat on the Word of God, the Bible says for you to study to show yourself approval and to meditate on the Word of God.
Yes.
In Romans 12, I believe it talks about
Jesus.
Renewing our mind. We need to renew our mind daily.
Mm-hmm.
Daily. We need to eat the Word. Our spirit, I found this out, Apostle, our spirit wants everything God has for us. But we have a war that's going on, and it's in the flesh. The flesh don't want to, but the spirit wants to. And so I thank God. Also, I was reading in Isaiah 50 in the fourth verse. When we begin to eat that word of God, and we begin to walk in his peace, he'll give us peace. He'll give us joy. He'll give us understanding. And what comes when you have that relationship with the Lord, and how important it is how important it is. Minister Jill talked about Proverbs 3rd chapter. And in the first verse, it says that if we begin to walk in his ways, if we begin to do his commandments and walk in his ways and around our way, our neck, there's mercy and grace. And to go a little bit further, what happens is God will give you favor. Mm. Favor is better than money. And this is a season God is releasing favor.
Yes.
The favor of the Lord. The favor of the Lord and favor with God and favor with people. Isaiah 50 in the fourth verse, he says that he has given you the tongue. When you begin to spend time with the Lord, Apostle, what happens is God will give you the tongue of the learned to speak words of wisdom to those that are weary in due season. And we have some weary people today.
Yes.
We have lots of weary people today.
Yes.
How important is it? You cannot waver. I remember years ago how the Lord told me that you cannot compromise. I had to get to a point in my life where I could not compromise. You know, if you fall short, repent. Hallelujah. But no more compromising.
That's
we
right.
need to do things. We need to spend time, and we need to spend time at his feet and the holy to be marinated in his presence, to worship the Lord in spirit and truth.
Yes.
He wants us to have that fellowship with him.
Yes.
And as I begin to even to sound the shofar, it's such an awesome thing. And I thank God for the privilege. Hallelujah. And God knows right where you are. Hallelujah. Holiness unto the Lord. Mm-hmm. It's a time to repentance and it's call for holiness. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And hallelujah. Well, glory to God. We are coming to a close. And as a matter of fact, that's going to be the closing note on that subject for this evening. But, you know, I believe by popular demand, we need to come back and do a part three. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we need to carry this further. I tell you, I've been so blessed myself while enjoying God's word. And glory to God. We have evangelist, hallelujah, Helen Celestine, that's going to give us a closing prayer on that subject. But just before she do, I just want to thank all of our guests, Dr. June Paul and Evangelist Joe Brandel and Pastor Josie and Evangelist Celestine. Amen. Let's give them all a hand clap. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we get ready, you hold hands at home as we do in the studio. And would you do the honors, just close us out in prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen. Father, we just thank you and we just praise you. Father, you are a good God.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we thank you for Jesus, the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, thank you, Lord, that you're our teacher. Father, you're everything we need you to be.
Yes,
Lord. We just thank you for the word.
Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you that Jesus is our obedience.
Thank you, Jesus.
Obedience, the word says, is better than sacrifice.
Yes, Lord.
And so, Father, we just delight in you today.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we thank you for the listening audience. Father, we thank you for the ones that are here. Father, I ask that you would bless your people, bless the body of Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Father, we ask the Lord bless us and keep us. Lord, make your face to shine upon us and
thank
be gracious
you, Jesus.
To us.
Hallelujah.
Lord, lift up your countenance on us and be gracious to us. Father, we ask you to give us your shalom.
Yes, Lord.
Your peace, your wholeness, your protection, your provision. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise
amen.
God.
Amen. And
hallelujah.
All the saints of God said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
God.
And we want to thank you from myself, Apostle Ronnie Bailey,
amen.
And from all of us at Rock of Ages Ministries. May God bless you. Until next time, this is our prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you.
tuning in today, and on behalf of Apostle Ronnie Bailey and all of our guests here at Rock of Ages Ministries, we hope that you will take these truths expressed on today's telecast and pass it on to others along your life's journey. We also pray that you join with us in taking this message around the world for Jesus. Remember, we can't beat God giving, no matter how hard we try, for the more we give unto Him, the more He'll give back unto us. Now, if you need prayer or counseling, please avail yourselves to our prayer and counseling hotline. The numbers are area code 337-706-7262 or 504-613-7234. If you would like to write us, please send all correspondence to Rock of Ages Ministries, 201 South College Road, Suite 214, Lafayette, Louisiana, 70503. And remember to add your prayer request. Our email address is ronnie@ronniebailey.com, and our website can be accessed anytime at ronniebailey.com. You may also watch our telecast on our brand new webcast channel at www.vo.com/channels/Rock of Ages TV, and enjoy our telecast anytime, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, at your convenience. Now, once again, we thank you for tuning in today. We trust that you've been blessed. Now, until next time, about this same scheduled time, may God bless you. This is our prayer.